So, hi, we are here with Julia Grandi from Jul Models. How are you?
Hi, Andrew. I'm very good. I'm at home, as most of us. And for those who doesn't know me, I'm a founder of the agency named Jul Models, based in Budapest, but running all around the world. And I'm also a director and producer for Vixen Media Group.
That's amazing. So tell me, Julia, how did you get into this whole beautiful, crazy industry?
Oh, it's been many years ago. I've been a performer myself for a short time, but then I started traveling and performing in different countries, and I realized that producers are looking for models. And I start bringing models with me on the shoots first, and then it's become too many performers, and I start to organize it as an agency. And since then, it's already 12 years I'm doing this, managing more than 200 porn stars at the moment.
Oh, wow.
And yeah, it's a recent situation.
That's great. So the models are based now in Budapest, all of them?
No, I'm working with models from different countries. So I do have many models coming from Russia and Ukraine, because I have roots coming from there. So I do have good connections over there to search performers. But I do have girls from all European countries, and not only Europeans. We start to work recently with Americans and even with the Japanese models. So we're growing and getting all over the world.
That's amazing. That's amazing. So tell me a bit, how does one become one of Jul Models? Like, how do I become one of your girls?
Normally, I have some talent scouts that reaching girls. Often it's happening that the girls are already doing some soft shoots, so they're doing some webcam, or maybe they just good-looking girls and boys, and talent scout reach them out and ask if they're interested in a certain job, and then we're sending them a link to fill the profile with many interesting questions. And then after this, I'm reviewing photos of them. I normally try to find time to have a personal talk and call with all of them. I don't have enough time to meet them as I did in the past, but I do have my managers that it's like obligatory to meet the girl personally before we start working, because it's important. She has to realize what she's going to do, where she's stepping in. And for me, I'm always trying to play very open and say that's industry going to change their life. In a good and in a bad way, you know, there's always two sides of the story, but we always give the full picture of what's going to happen to her life as soon as she starts to work with us.
How did this COVID-19 thing affect you personally and Jul Models, if it has?
Me personally, the biggest affection is traveling part. As a producer and director, and just as a big fan of traveling, I've been traveling all the time, and now it's strange. I don't really feel it that bad yet, but I guess one more month and I will start crying about it. So
I'm there.
you feel this, and then another part, of course, I miss my friends, I miss my family, but things we have there, all the video calls and things like this to stay in touch. It's not the same, but it's an alternative way of being in touch at the moment. Professionally, the biggest effect is, of course, is the agency work connected directly with the bookings for the production. So right now there is no productions happening, so all the bookings been canceled by agency. So basically, no one of our girl is doing production work, like when she's going to some company to work for. But that's the biggest effect. So we try to support girls as we can. We're running now a new project, so we are making girls to create their profiles on different platforms that monetize their content.
Okay.
Helping them with registration, education, how to run it properly, how to work with the self-made content, how to promote it, how to run traffic onto these pages, and then Right now we are trying to bring all of the girls into this platform. So all my managers and workers in the agency, they switch of helping them of creating something. Them, of course, we have some small referral revenues from that, and that helps the agency to survive at the moment. And basically, it's looking that we're having lots of jobs to do right now, and girls are busy, and we try to help them, and it's growing. And I always wanted, and it's not that we just started to do this. We've been doing this for a while, that the girls been working with their, you know, premium Snapchats and things like this, or even personal websites. But it was like selective girls, the top models, and mm-hmm. now based on this experience we are teaching other girls, and also we are trying to make that the girls who've been already doing this teaching the new girls, so they're helping each other, I guess.
Oh, that's amazing. And they stay, some of your models, they stay in the same house, right?
We do have a house. It's a webcam house. It's not the house where the girls do webcam. It's just a 24 hours streaming. So okay. It's happened there by accident that some of the performers couldn't go back to their countries because of the lockdown. So we had agreement with them that they will stay in this house. I will make sure they have everything they need. But they have only one rule, to be safe there. So they're not allowed to go out. I mean, they are allowed to go. They have their own garden and a barbecue place and things like this. And they can go for a walk. But they're not allowed to meet with anyone else out of this house because it's a big number of people. It's 8 person staying there. Oh. So, but they are doing fine. They're actually happy that they stayed. So they're shooting lots of content. And we're discussing many new projects with them at this moment. But all the other girls who are in different countries, we are in same in contact with them. We are helping them out. So it's lots of work, lots of new thing. And we'll see where we go after this. Because I think that will become a part of their normal life, to create own content and to monetize it.
Absolutely. So,
and I'm happy about, because right now in Europe, we don't have enough production shots for all the models. I have just too many girls, not enough work. So it will be helpful for them. And you know, all the girls who've been lazy in the past right now start to finally move and finally listen to us, that don't wait while the work come to you. Just organize yourself and make some money online. So that's the news.
But this is like what you're doing, I think it's amazing. You're basically setting up these girls for success. So you're helping them from the start, from doing the shoots, the tests, the everything. Then you're keeping them safe. Then you're teaching them how to create content. Then you're teaching them how to monetize it.
I guess the biggest issue with all of these platforms is just there's so many, first of all, and like all of them, they're similar but different, and the girls get lost because there's no, like, you know, they learn something about one thing, then it doesn't work on another platform. So we have to help them to surf there and to make sure that they get maximum from every place they work with. And it's also important for them to organize themselves. So mm-hmm. they used to be very well organized by the agency. So right now we just switch our things we help them, so we organize for them, so we make actually planning when they shoot, when they upload, and how they upload, how they promote. So it's important, because all of this platform, they have so many girls registered but so many dead profiles that are not alive. So our idea is to finally make the girls really working on this platform, not just to create the content, put and then wait, like, well, what's happening? where is my money? Money will not come just if you shoot the content and put it online, maybe only just on tubes. But that's, yeah. So we work with all these platforms, tubes, and we also educate girls how to work with the referral links, how to become an affiliate, because we teach them how to make money on already existing content. Okay. Because they shot lots of movies, so they right now they're getting their personal links, and they can promote it more for their fans, because probably some of the fans didn't see all of their work. And it's a good possibility now to direct them to the right place to spend some money, and that they can get some cut. So they actually, models are surprised, because most of them, they had no idea that they can make money out of ready shot scenes, because for them was like, you know, she wants to go to the shooting, she makes money, she come back home, that's it. So now they discovering a complete new world of affiliates and referral links and revenues. So it's,
but this, you offered this option, this knowledge meant to all the models that are working with Jul Models, right?
Yeah, we're starting right now with the exclusive girls, because we do have some girls that are working, you know, with some different agencies, depending on the countries, because it's huge. So some girls, like, you know, they work in Hungary with us, and they work in Czech Republic with other agency, just because it's location wise makes sense. And but with the exclusive girls, we are pushing them first, and of course we give them more time and education, but we still didn't arrive to the to reach everyone. We are on the process. Unfortunately, our team isn't enough for now to really control and follow this, so we're hiring in this time, we're hiring more people to help them out. And I guess it's also big help that I'm not leaving my team without work. And then everybody's busy, and so there's a good and a bad part. Of course, it's a bad what's happening in the world. It's not a question, but you know, it's the right time to teach them to switch their preferences, because, you know, they understand that the work on the production is cannot be all the time. And I will be very happy if they secure with all these platforms. And
that's great. That's amazing. So tell me a bit about the whole process. So you find the girl, she comes to you, walk me through it.
Okay, she comes to me. Yeah, there's two type of girls I'm finding. First, it's the one that goes directly to the agency, and second, of course, I have my personal scouting for my own production that has a different view, like more direct you on this. So let's talk about the agency one. So the girls normally hit by talent scout or finding us herself. There's many girls right now that applying themselves. It's much different than years before.
How do they find you? Where do they find you? Where can we find you?
We do work a lot with the social network, so we put lots of advertisement, and we me and my team is making lots of interviews and lots of publicity. So we make sure that the girls always that already work with us promote us, that other girls can find where to go. I actually don't know exactly how they find us, but they always find us. You know, so some of people, like, you know, some of companies, they always cry like, oh, we don't have enough models. Me, I have opposite problem. I don't know what to do with so many models. So that's the thing. I have too many models, and you know, all of them are important to me. So I'm trying to, you know, to not to cut someone out, but to find the time and to grow the team to give attention to each of them.
Okay. So they find you, and
After she applies, she'll have to send her ID. Normally, you know, if it's a new model, she's shy, you know, like she doesn't know us personally. So we give her possibility to cover important numbers. So important for me to check her date of birth. So she's over 18. It's the number one thing to check, then to understand that it's a legal person, that it's not someone fake trying to work us. So many fake people that try to apply to the agency. Then after this, we're doing a Skype call or just a normal call. We talk with the girls what experience she had or she had not at all. Then we send her a questionnaire where she say all this what about her look and attach her photos. And after this, we tell her a little bit more about industry, about the scenes, how it's happening. So what exactly her work day will look like. We spend lots of time of talking about medical things, that it's not protected most of the time shots. So we are following on the medical tests of each performer, how it's important and what's because it's important they understand from the beginning, once they enter this industry, they are not just responsible for themselves anymore. They're responsible for the big group of people working together with them. So they can't anymore, you know, have unprotected sex around or have some crazy parties or things like this, because they are not single anymore. Let's put it this way. They are part of the group, and the group is big. And also, you know, it's a worldwide thing. So, you know, it's important, not just, you know, in a small community of one country, it's spreading all around. So we try to spend some time to explain this. And after this, normally, you know, some girls are ready to start directly with everything just because they're looking for money. So, and we are fine with this. So if she wants to start directly with boy, girl, or girl, girl scene, it's her decision. Some of the girls starting slowly, so they do some solo work at the beginning, and we provide them solo work at first, and then
what does solo work mean?
Solo work is the girl when she's alone in front of the camera, so basically it's okay. Masturbation or play with the toy and things like this. So basically it's the like easiest work. I mean, for me, I always consider that's the hardest work, because to find out what to do 20 minutes with one toy, it was always questionable. what will you do 20 minutes with one toy? Because it's like not so many, you know, in the interaction not happening. So I personally like when the girl starting with girl-girl movies, if she likes girls, of course. Mm-hmm. Because it teach her more about emotions, because it's like less, you know, physical act, more about emotions and playing in front of camera. And then she become more open, and then she can start more successful way of doing boy-girl scene. When it's coming to boy-girl scene, we always try to make for the girls like a right career building. We start with the bigger brands of on exclusive deal, often, not all the time. It's all depend on the girl. If she feels like to do one big movie or one big scene for the bigger company, and then like wait until it's released and see how people react, we always support this. So she's like taking it slowly. If she just looking for a quick money, because in our situation they come into the business different. Some people that really need this money. So then she just come over. We try to organize, we call it a first tour. We bring the girl to Budapest because we're based here. And then she stay here in our model house. That I told before, and then during 3 weeks she's going to different productions every day, and they're making different movies for different companies. If the girl doing good, she has a break after 3 weeks, and then she's coming back again and again. And after this, when the companies already knows her, they inviting her for the special movies and projects. So like this is like we call it tour, because girls are coming and they're kind of independent from production. So they're not attached to one company only. They're only attached to the agency. Mm-hmm. To give them possibility to work, like, you know, on the standard city rates, what's valid here in Budapest. And also, you know, like they can understand for themselves which companies they like, which companies they doesn't like, which style they like. And of course, if the girls has a problem with any type of shooting, we never push, and we try to slow down them. So if the girl is ready to jump in into the water, I will say like come on, let's see, let's do this, you know, step by step. Don't need to, you know, to go to a gangbang shooting straight away on the first scene, you know. It just doesn't make sense. Maybe it makes sense if it's her dream, but I know that it might hurt her after all, because she might start to create, you know, emotional things that it wasn't right. So if she's slowly going like harder scenes and things like this, I find it more correct way of building her career. And of course, you know, then the girls are flying all over Europe, or even not only Europe. We start to work now with Japan, with America. So if the girl is pretty, it helps her a lot. If the girl is smart, it helps her more, because it's about a relationship at the end of the story. So if she's nice to the production, if she's nice to the people around, they're going to call her, even though there is another girl much prettier than her, and, you know, she has nicer boobs and nicer eyes. It's it's not all about boobs and eyes. It's also about how she behaves in front of camera and how she behaves with the people, you know, with who she works. You know, so that's basically how the career started. And then it's all depend on the girl, how long she want to stay. We're not cutting the careers. So if the girl want to do a long-term relationship, we're only happy. So.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's really great. You're taking care of them. You're like leading them their way. And that's great. I mean, I've heard so many performers coming in and doing exactly like you said, gangbang scene, their first scene. And they're like, okay, now what?
No, I'm against this, not because of the certain companies, it's the style, you know, many people like this type of the work. But I think, you know, like it's kind of, I don't know, it will not run away from her. She can do it later, anytime, you know. And first of all, she needs to be sure that this is the thing she wants to do. So I don't think the girl will, you know, cry if she did the solo as the first scene, rather than she'll cry if she had a scene with 10 boys and all the crazy action. You know, like for me, I like crazy action. I have no problem with this, but it should be the right time for each girl to accept this. So yeah, and at the same time, we also, you know, when the girl arrived from the first day, she come, let's say, to Budapest. So first 3 days, she is not working on the on any production. She's doing medical tests. We're going to talk with her again if she's ready, if she's okay to start. We're going to go through this. She's going to meet other people, other performers in the house. If that goes okay, now we start with registering her straight away on the platforms, like main with who we work with, we cooperate. So she already... She understand that work right now, it's not just to go to make a scene for the production. It's a work, it's to also to be in touch with the fans, to be a social active. And without this, it's impossible. In past, it was like this. You come to make one movie, you're already a star. So you don't need to, you know, you're one scene is enough to become a porn star. Not now, not anymore. If you are not social active, if you don't, you know, like communicate with your fans, and growing your own, you know, fan followers. So it just doesn't work, you know, even if you're super pretty, it just doesn't work. So yeah, I have a companies that call Jul Models and say like, okay, we need a girl for next week shooting with the maximum number of Twitter followers. So they don't even care who the girl, they just...
Oh, really?
Yeah, so that's how it's changed. This is the new thing in the industry.
Wow.
So yeah. Some of
Kim Kardashian screwed us up, hasn't she?
Yeah, right. Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god. Okay, wow, that's really interesting. That's really interesting. So do you think that throughout your experience working with production, working with models, seeing what the clients, the members want, the users want, have you seen a change in the profile of the I think it's a strong word, but the perfect porn star? Have you seen a change in how she would look, how she would behave, the type of scene that she does?
I think the perfect porn star right now, at the moment, it's the one that is very connected with her fans and the growing fans follower base. So that's I think number one, because I had a girl that explained the situation. She comes to Budapest and she work only with her boyfriend. And you know, she's a pretty girl. I find her very pretty, but you know, by that moment we couldn't find her like lots of work. So she'd been doing just a few things, and then she was about to leave and said, listen, let's try this, you know, premium Snapchat things. And then she said, yeah, I want to try because like I don't have nothing else to do, you know, like production don't want to shoot me. I said like, but come on, don't take it personal, it just happened, you know, maybe bad timing or whatever. And then she started doing this, and right now she become number one models from mine, who is making lots of money on premium Snapchat, and all other girls are looking at her like, wow, she really took that and she proved it. And now, of course, all the productions wants to work with her because now it works back.
It works.
All her ratings up, you know, on all these tubes and things like this. Yeah, and now, of course, productions wants to work with her, but now she has a question, do she need to work for these productions? So, yeah.
That's amazing. Like the models that the performers that are watching this should understand this. Like, look how important social media is.
If production doesn't want to shoot you, then it's only you doing something wrong. It's not about that they are bad productions or they don't like you. And it's not always about how the girls look like, you know, because there's a niche for every girl. There is a way of improve your performance in any direction. So just find your way and also talk with your managers and they will help you. But, you know, many girls are getting like very emotional. Like, for example, if they come over here and they don't get enough of work, you know, for there's maybe 100 reasons why not enough of work for that timing, you know, maybe too hot in Budapest or too cold or too, you know, like whatever, you know. It's funny because when it's too hot, it's, you know, hard to work in the studios, it's hard to work outside. When it's when it's winter, it's too short light day, and not all companies work with the artificial light. So but the girls then get angry at us that we didn't find them work. But it's we can always direct, we can support, we can advise, but we cannot make productions choose certain girl. They have access to all the girls, and it's up to them who they will choose. But they always listen for the advice, and they're more often not advice of the agency, like, you know, like, this girls is great. They listen about, you know, performers, guys talking about the girls, that they've been working with this girl in another production, and then she's been great. They're reviewing other companies' work, so they can see if the girl been good or not. So it's all mm-hmm. dependent. If the girl did one, two great scene, she can be sure that other people will see this or will hear about that she's great, and they will book her for sure.
That's really good. That's really good info. I wanted to ask, I've seen you at trade show. I've seen you going around at trade shows, meeting with people. What are you looking for?
It's a good question.
What do you want? What do you want, and what can you offer? Like, what can you offer? What do you want?
So in past, it was I've been looking for integrate my models into all these online platforms, as I said before. So I knew that there is a possibility to make money online, but of course it's you new because you're always on trade show, and the problem of this trade show even right now is that you always talk to each other. But there's no one that tells this to models that, you know, models, they don't come most from most of the trade shows. So there is a broken connection between the product and the person who's going to use this product. So I decided that I will be this connection. So I went to the first trade show to collect this information. We start working with certain platforms and companies, and that gave us result. Then later I decided that we can work with more of companies like that. And I start to learn more about all this online money making, and then it's also, you know, it's great because right now what we're discovering is a new way of that now it's important. In past it was like, you know, pay sites and the traffic and all this around and all connected how to maintain this industry. Now it's so many work connected to the models directly, you know, how they work with these platforms. But the problem still, models, they don't come to this trade show. So it's only me who come back from trade shows and tell them, okay, there is 10 new platforms and I don't know how it's working, but we're going to find out. So I'm calling these people and say, like, listen, I have girls, they don't know how to use your platform. I have to learn myself and then to forward this information to them. So that's what, one of the reasons I'm going. And then also right now we find out that models and their social traffic is becoming big as well. So right now, like, for example, with the girls who I'm working with, if I want to say something loud on Twitter, and because they work with me, I can ask them to say for me, and they will do because, you know, they follow or they support me. So if I want to say something tomorrow, all Jul Models girls will post, we will reach around 5 million unique followers on Twitter. That's a big number. And around 2.5 million on Instagram, because it just gets blocking so often. So yeah, it's still big numbers. So it means that right now I can also, you know, to have this power. So if we need to do some sales or if we need to redirect this traffic to some other places, that's my last trade show was about, couple meeting was about that. In past we've been looking for traffic, and now we can actually give this traffic to other sources because we do have, if we put all this followers together, and then it's a big number. So they just don't know how to use it. So they trust me that I will find a way how to organize that well and how to help them to make some extra money. And for me, it's for now, it's lots of still questions how to make it proper because it's all new. Nobody consider models as a source of traffic. Now they start to think, you know, like I remember 3 years ago, been sitting on one pay site meetup, and they start talking about like what we do with these followers of the girls, like are they interested for us as the customers. Of course they are, they are direct fans, but those time they was kind of just trying to bring the girls into the game. So, and it was the first time when they've been sending, you know, links and trailers and photos for the girls. In past, nobody been taking care of this, you know, girls having profiles, company has a profiles, they have affiliates and things like this, but nobody was considering girls to be actually an affiliate for their own content or for any other content can be. So that's also changing, and we will see how it will go. So, and for the rest of the time on trade show, I'm meeting great people. I'm discussing lots of things. I'm getting some support in my new ideas, some advices, and I'm learning a lot, because, you know, it's changing so quick, so fast, that, you know, like one trade show to another trade show, you do already new things happening in the industry. So that's the reason I'm coming there, and I will come more often.
That's perfect. Well, you are coming to Bucharest Summit. What are your expectations from the show?
So the first expectation for me, because it's this type of summit, like Bucharest Summit, for me it's a good reason to bring my models together. And finally, it's not only me who will get all information and pass this to them. I will just have all of them with me, not maybe all of them. There is no summit that can afford all of my models at the same time. But at least, you know, some of the girls who are really into this, I can have them with me so they can visit all this, you know, meetups and check for themselves what's good for them, what they want to try, what they don't want to try. And they can learn about lots of new things, because I've been like that many years ago. I've been just going everywhere, listening. Okay, that's for me. That's not for me. That's for me. And that's how bring these little things bring me where I am right now. And I hope it will be helpful for them. And then, of course, it's also fun time, because it's lots of fun things happening, especially in Bucharest Summit. Was a great proposal. I couldn't say no. Yeah, and you know, like I will be very honest, to entertain my girls myself, sometimes it's just too hard work. So if there's any place where there's some entertainment and the same time with education for them, it's a great possibility for me. And also my managers are very happy that we can have trips like this.
Absolutely.
And at the same time, you know, if the girls are together with me, believe me, they will not just visit the show and then go back to the hotel and sleep. They will make sure, I will make sure they shoot lots of content, because it's like, it's not every time there are so many top girls in the same place. So we make sure that they take maximum from meeting each other. And Bucharest Summit is a good reason to meet all of them. And
We are actually planning this, and we did talk about this. This is me and Julia, what we talked about. A lot of performers will come to Bucharest Summit, and you will have the opportunity, the locations to shoot content. So if you want to, you know, change the scenery, learn something, meet some of Jul models, learn stuff, create content, understand how to work and make more money, this is the place to be.
So for any companies that have something to offer to the models, whether it's a new platform or new idea or new website or things or anything new, you know, it's going to be like there's so many things what models can make right now themselves. So if you have anything new to offer to my models, or just maybe again explain them the old stuff, I will make sure that they will be there listening for you. And me myself, I will be also there listen about the new technologies. And yeah, and if there will be possibility for my girls to meet other girls out of Jul Models, that is also very important, because okay, we are a big strong community of the performers, you know, not only girls, because we're talking mostly about girls, but it's boys and girls and couples. But if they have possibility to meet other girls, I don't know, say some Romanian girls that are great online, or some other nationalities girls, so I will be happy if they can cross shoot some content and make best out of this. You know, it will be good for all of them.
That's amazing. That's the goal, basically, to travel, and not only to travel and gain experience and gain knowledge, but to also monetize that time that you're traveling.
Absolutely. We recently been just before lockdown, I've been taking my few, so many, it was 15 girls to 13 girls, sorry, plus two assistants, 13 girls to Austria. So we went for 4 days. We've been snowboarding and skiing. So we had the teachers and lessons of skiing and snowboarding. And after lunchtime, we've been shooting content and they've been doing lots of cross promotion on their social networks. And then they've been so happy when we come back and after this lockdown happened, because they have in their pocket around 30 videos with all the girls, different combinations. So it was just the girls. So it was like, you know, girl, or more. And we had the group scene, but they are happy that all of them, they can be okay for next month because, you know, they are locked at home, so they can do, you know, solo single content, or maybe if they have boyfriend or girlfriend at home, they can do something. But like this, they have a variety and they have possibility to surprise their fans with the content that recently shot just before lockdown.
That's amazing. That's such a good idea. That's such a great thing. And I know that I've seen your work, and I've seen where you take the girls. And this month is Ibiza, then it's Austria, then it's I don't know where. I just want to be one of your girls.
Are you sure?
No, for now I'm good. Is it a market?
I can send you a link for the registration.
I'm sure. Okay, so Julia, what do you think we should all learn after this whole pandemic is over, both like personally and professionally?
I think personally, we have to change our opinion of what valuable things in the life for us. So I definitely will cry less about that, you know, certain things are too difficult in my life, because now I understand that it's my life is treasure and it's been amazing, and I want to continue this way. To stay at home is wonderful, but for a short time, absolutely. So personally, of course, I will value more the real meetings with people. I will value more time with my family and with my friends. I promise to all of them, don't be on the phone every time I'm meeting with them, because that's been stupid. I can be on the phone when it's lockdown like that. So I will dedicate my time for the personal meetings. That's important for me personally. And then for professional, I think, you know, like we have no security that we cannot be sure that it will not happen again. And I want to be sure that next time, if I will be happy if it never happened next time, but I want to make sure that my models, first of all, and me are prepared and we are not in panic when that's happening. So we know exactly what's our step to do, how to protect ourselves, how to protect our work, and how not to go into deep hole of depression and money problems with losing the work. So because we are lucky to have this industry that can be done online partly, so then we have to use benefits out of this. So we need to be ready for next time, or if it's never next time, just to use all the benefits what we learned during this time to be comfortable with our work.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. That it's just about being grateful. It's just about learning how to appreciate. And this thing with the phone, I promise I won't use my phone around my friends anymore. It is exactly like you said. It is crazy that we didn't take that time and weren't that grateful of actually sharing, you know, hugs and just being with a person next to you. This is crazy. Well, next time we'll do it. The first time we're going to drop our phone somewhere. Just tell everyone where we are and just find us there.
Can't wait you to see in Bucharest Summit. I'm not sure if we can see each other before, but if we can, we definitely will use this chance. Absolutely. I hope you're staying safe, and I hope there will not be changes of the date of Bucharest Summit, because I locked my days for this trip already, and I'm looking forward to it.
No, the dates stay as they are, and we're really, you know, fingers crossed so that we all get safe out of it. Like us personally, our clients, our models, everyone gets out of this, and our families as well get out of this safe and happy. Thank you so much, Julia. You have been amazing. Thank you.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it. Bye.